In college, do you feel at one point that the monster of fun got the best of you?
Oh, 100%. I remember people reaching out to me that were people I had on a bucket list of people to meet, celebrities. I remember buying a sweatshirt off Drake's website and then having them email me afterwards and just having a conversation with Drake a month later. Kid from where I'm from, 20,000 people, we don't get the chance to meet celebrities, much less meet everyone that you would want or have a chance to talk to them at the tip of your fingers. So after that first year, after the fame and everything started to come, I couldn't help but eat it up.
So naturally, you get engulfed by it. Women, parties, drugs, I get it. Now me personally, only reason why I never went down the drug lane is because my dad was on drugs. I got to see firsthand what it did. But if you don't get to see that, naturally you can fall into it without understanding why or how. Was there a point in school where you felt like you had to check yourself? Or were you just riding with it?
I felt like I was the guy that had to party to be able to play good.
Yeah, you became a celebrity. You became a celebrity and you weren't even looking for the fame.
Let's keep it going. Let's get a little deeper into this conversation.
What are you talking about? What are you talking about getting in?
Yeah.
I'm so wrapped up into the conversation.
Conversation.
It's a great conversation.
You can't forget what we're here for, though.
Man, what? I got my watch on. I gotta stay out here. I didn't even think about it. Jump. What you doing, brother? What you? Get your goddamn hands. Get your hands off me. Pervert. All right, Johnny. You get the Heisman. That there has to be the biggest boost of confidence at all.
I went from fourth on the depth chart that spring of 2012, to 11 days in the camp winning the job. 6 months later, I'm on the stage in New York winning the Heisman. And then 10 months from there, I'm turning in my paperwork and getting a first or second round grade back to go to the draft.
You get on that stage, that's a dream. Holy s***. And then you find out it's the Cleveland Browns. How'd that feel?
At the time, all my boys, everyone in my corner was telling me, you don't want to go to Cleveland. Like, f*** that. I looked at it, I was more optimistic about it. I looked at the players they had, I was cool with it.
Jesus. He said his boy said, f*** that, no, man.
Once I landed and went to Berea, Ohio for the first time, I was like, can I go back to college? I don't know anybody. I don't know where I'm at. It's cold. I don't like it. That's pretty much how it was.
My butt hurts. How am I gonna do it?
I didn't know what it took. I didn't know like how much hard work you really had to put in to like be good. I just felt like when I went out that first day and I was kind of like, all right, I'm gonna go see how this thing goes. And it went so bad, that just compounded into my home life. If I'm not doing good at what my job is and what I love, like how can I go home and be happy about other things that are going on? I'm in a little bubble in Cleveland. Can't hide like I used to in the past. So I'm finding different ways to try and hide and get out of who I am. Cause I don't like what's going on right now. I don't like who I am right now.
Yeah, 100%.
Hi, I'm Kevin Hart. And unless you hate laughter, click and subscribe. And if you do hate laughter, then you're a monster.